I think that grief is a constant companion throughout the illness, actually. Therese Rando, a colleague of mine, has a wonderful way of, she uses the term anticipatory mourning, and she often says anticipatory grief is a misnomer, but useful nonetheless. And what she means by that is that as we begin a process of illness, the old way of understanding anticipatory grief was that you were anticipating the fact that someone was going to die, and you were grieving almost in anticipation or as if that person were dead. We now know that what you're really doing is you're grieving all the losses associated with the illness. The loss of maybe contact, the loss of a dream, the loss of different abilities. I had a good friend of mine die a number of years ago from ALS, Lou Gehrig's disease. And this guy was a fascinating conversationalist and a very easy person to talk with. And at the time of his death, when I talked with his wife, she said something that really resonated with me and I fully understood. She said even worse than Kurt's death was when he lost his power of speech. So I think throughout the illness, there's a constant dealing with grief. But of course, once the person is dead, that's another loss, and that's another form of grief as well.